Welcome.
Hey there, I'm Morgan and we're in the Jackrabbit Hollow. On today's show, I'm going to show you the wonderful world of home winery and meading. I'm going to show you how to make a nice home brew, wine or mead. The recipe is interchangeable. Step 1, brewing. You're going to need an acid solution. You can use citric acid blend from a home wine brewing store. Lemons.
Acid blend helps preserve the wine. Acid blend is a blend of citric, malic, and tartaric acid, and is a good balanced product to use. You can substitute the juice of one lemon for 1 teaspoon of acid blend in most recipes. Pectin enzyme is an enzyme that eats pectin. Pectin is the stuff in some fruits that causes them to gel when cooked. In winemaking, it results in a haze. Some fruits are high in pectin, others very low. The enzyme, in pectic enzyme, is killed off by the heat. So, always make sure your must is tepid before you add it.
Sugar for wine, honey for mead.
Wine yeast.
Everything else I've got here is just for fun. You don't really need it for the basics, but I'm going to show it to you anyways. Yeast energizer. This is a vitamin to start your yeast and your musty wine off with. Yeast nutrient. This helps get stuck wines back into fermentation. Tannins
are an astringent compound that give a dryness to the mouthfeel of a wine. It's the same feeling that dries out your tongue when you drink coffee or tea. Tannin also helps clear and stabilize the wine. You can find tannin in many things. Tea, coffee, the barks of some trees, or you can just buy some tannin at your home brewing store. Tannin can also be used to help heal burns, and it also helps clot blood in the case of an emergency.
Airlocks. Additives such as wood chips and spices.
Cinnamon sticks are also nice. Here's an easy process for making a bung airlock.
Take an old coffee bag. The airlock is right here in the middle. It lets air escape but does not let air back in. Cut it out. Take the lid of your vessel and punch a hole through it. At your airlock there, we're gonna outline that lid. Place your cutout circle inside your lid with the hole in it. Now, when we twist this on our vessel to seal up that lid, the rim will press up against our little airlock sheet and seal that hole, letting gases escape, but not letting other yeasts and pathogens or air back in. Here's a little baby version. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make a basic pineapple mead or wine. This recipe can be translated into any fruit juice or grape juice. This is a 1 gallon recipe. We're going to start by making our pineapple must.
Must is freshly pressed fruit juice that contains the skins, seeds, and stems of the fruit. The solid portion of the must is called pomace. The length of time that the pomace stays in the juice is critical for the final character of the wine. When the winemaker judges the time to be right, the juice is drained. The yeast is then added to the juice to begin the fermentation process.
Make sure you got ripe pineapples. Just tug on any one of those middle leaves, and if they come out with ease, that pineapple is nice, sweet, and ready. Try one that doesn't defy me so much. You can blend your pineapples up in a blender or use a food processor. Just add a cup of clean filtered water and blend it up. Now add your pineapple must to the jar. We're gonna add 2 pounds of sugar or honey. Dissolve your honey or sugar in a couple cups of cool, clean water by simmering it on medium. Crystallized honey works especially nice. 1 cup is a 1/2 pound. We're gonna need 4 cups of sweet stuff. I've decided to make a 1/2 and 1/2. Simmer until it's all dissolved. We're going to add 1 teaspoon of citric acid, acid blend, or the juice of 1 lemon, or the juice of 2 limes. Now is also a good time to add a half a teaspoon of any vitamins, energizers, or nutrients. Pour your dissolved honey or sugar mixture over your pineapple mustiness. Stir the mixture together.
Winemaking is an art that is thousands of years old. Wine residue has been found inside of clay jugs in the ruins of an old Middle Eastern fort dating 1,000 years before Christ. The skins of wine grapes carry wild yeasts, which were probably responsible for the first container of grape juice accidentally fermenting into wine.
Top off your gallon of must and sweet with cool, clean water. Add half a teaspoon of pectic enzyme after the must has cooled. Now is the time to add the tannins if you're wanting a dry wine or neat.
Traditional wine is made using only grape juice because the grapes contain the wine acid, tannins, and wild yeasts necessary for fermentation. Wines made with fruit and sugar are typically known as fruit wines and have added acids, tannins, and yeast. Mead is a form of wine made with strictly honey and water. Variations of mead using melons and honey would be referred to as mellow mel. Honey brewed with herbs is known as metheglin, and many variations of fruit and vegetable meads that have yet to be named. Basically, wine refers to grape juice, fruit wine refers to fruit and sugar, and anything used with honey is generally a type of mead.
We're going to cover this with our airlock for 24 hours, and then we're going to come back and add the yeast. You can add your special ingredients at any time in the brewing process. French toasted oak chips. Another item you may want is a hydrometer. So we use the hydrometer to measure the sugar content because the wine will digest up to 14% alcohol and then it will kill itself with its alcohol content. If we have under that 14% amount of sugar, we're going to get a dry wine. The wine must needs to maintain at least 9% alcohol to store well.
Juice concentrates can be used in place of fruit. Wine and alcohol can often be referred to as spirits, which is why the brew down is especially important, making sure your wine is brewed in the best of environments, so the spirit experienced will be loving and friendly.
Here's some wine yeasts I purchased from a home brewing store. Each packet will take care of about 5 gallons of wine. Montrachet. Montrachet is a good beginner's yeast. Premier Cuvée is a good yeast for helping stuck fermentation start again. Pasteur Champagne. Never tried it before. Maybe now's a good time to try it. K1V1116, product of Canada. Oh, a Canadian wine, eh? Oh, yeah, sure. If you want that wine to taste like a nice Canadian wine, that's the one you'll want to get. EC118, also a product of Canada. France. Denmark. Canada. All of these I've used for wine and mead making. You can use the whole packet just to be sure. I'm gonna finish off a little bit of Denmark. 24 hours after letting that pineapple must sit around, add that yeast. You can dissolve it in water or just add it.
My liver's job sitting on the fence, and I haven't seen a damn thing since. Worked all night with a bottle in my hand. Come on and give the fiddle a dram, fiddle a dram, fiddle a dram. Come on and give the fiddle a dram.
It is important to write messages of gratitude, love, and kindness on your fermenting vessels, simply to encourage prosperous fermentation, flavor, and bountiful alcohol contents. The Feline Wine and Mead Awareness Squad. We recommend 1 feline for every 10 gallons of wine or mead to guide a hen and bring awareness to your fermenting vessels.
Racking. Racking is siphoning the wine, the must, from one container to a new vessel whilst leaving the sediment behind. You're going to want to rack your wine 1 week after brewing, then again at 1 month after brewing, and again at 3 months after brewing, and then every 6 months until you're ready to bottle it. Your musty wine ready to rack. A new vessel to transfer your wine into. A siphoning tube. A bowl. A sanitizing solution. You can make this solution by taking any bottle of water and adding 8 sulfite tablets.
You can also boil or steam to sanitize.
We're not going to put this in the wine, we're just going to use it to sanitize and sterilize our equipment. Pour your sanitizer solution into your empty vessel and shake it around to sanitize the sides of the jar. And then pour it into your bowl. Now use your sanitizing solution in your bowl to clean out your siphoning tube.
Don't spit in it.
Make sure all your equipment is sterilized. Place your empty vessel at a lower spot than your full vessel. Lower one end of your siphoning tube into your musty wine
to just above the sediment level.
With a clean mouth, start your siphon going by sucking the wine, the musty wine, out of one jaw into another. Discard the sediment. Top it off with clean, filtered water. Replace the lid or airlock and write the date that you racked it. Let it sit another 3 to 6 months and rack it again, or bottle it if it's ready. Each time I rack the wine, I leave more and more sediment behind as the wine clears out. And when there's little to no sediment left and the wine is crystal clear, it's ready for bottling.
Fermented beverages have been preferred over water throughout the ages. They are safer, provide psychotropic effects, and are more nutritious. Some have even said alcohol was the primary agent for the development of Western civilization. Since more healthy individuals, even if inebriated much of the time, lived longer and had greater reproductive success.
Bottling is very similar to racking. We're going to siphon our wine, ready wine, mead, out of one bottle into our little bottles and cork them up for good until we drink them. First thing, I want to sterilize my jars. A little bit of sanitizing solution. Shake it around, pour it out. You can use this sulfite sanitizing solution as long as it smells like nasty rotten eggs. It's just good. Or sulfur. I mean, not everybody knows what sulfur smells like. Transfer the remaining liquid back into your storage container. Sulfite solution. Sanitize your hose. Should be good. Bottles at a lower elevation. Submerge your siphoning tube to the sediment level. Just above the sediment level. Start that siphon going. Fill each bottle to just where the neck starts to curve up to. For each gallon of wine or mead that you're bottling, you will need 5 regular-sized wine bottles. I'm using recycled wine bottles. They work just fine. Bottling. A bottle of wine must ready to rack and bottle. Corks. You can buy these from any home brewing supply store. I recommend a lever action corker. Drop your corks into boiling water. Load one of your sanitized corks into onto your corker. Place your loaded corker on top of your ready-to-cork bottle. And pull that lever action down. Give it a little press to get it all the way. I corked that bottle. Make sure to label that bottle and give it a birthday. I consider the day I brew it the birthday.
Wine and mead have been used in ceremonies and gatherings for centuries. A great reason to brew your own wine or mead is to avoid those not-so-good additives used in commercial brews, to use local, natural ingredients, and to ensure that your spirits are raised in the best of environments with good intention and energy. And it will be well worth the wait when you bring out that bottle of homebrew to share at a gathering of family and friends. It is in the spirit where living is truly experienced. Be sure not to neglect it. Experience every moment to its fullest, and remember, if you must, you will eventually have wine. Well, that's all for this season. Till the next time.
There's just nothing like a good homemade wine. Ain't that right? Salud! Going to need. Wow. Here's some wine yeasts I purchased from a help. That's my scare. No. This wasn't it.
Beet line.
Son of a bitch.
It was 3 long years past when the journey began. A new must born into a world of yeasty possibilities. And above all, endless love. The ferment never gave a hint at stopping, pushed through even at the coldest of hours. A bed of oaken apples and toasted cinnamon lag patiently in wait of arrival. The journey would be long, the wait almost unbearable. Awaiting trial at first glance and consumption long awaited, would she love me? Would she find me suitable to every heavenly taste? The moment grew near, and as fast as the hours and years came and passed, swiftly and never ending at times, I felt the moment when I touched her sweet lips, and as falling to my final fate, I looked back to see a small, Celestine smile peer back at me. I knew it was worth the wait.